Okay, for this one, I will begin again with the XY. We start with the circle, select the origin as a center, and we start with the smaller one from that smaller end. And that's the smallest one we have is diameter at 0.25. Finish the sketch, extrude. And the length of this one is, if you want to do the math, you can do the math, or just do the calculation here. If you look at this paper that you have, PDF version, you have total of 5 points. That's what I'm going to do right now. Just type 5.0625 minus, if you take that 4.1875, gives you the difference on these, this part. So you can do that math separately, just type them there or just take the calculation right on the computer within the Inventor itself. Now come back here and select this face and select that face as a work plane and start the same origin as a center and draw another circle. It's slightly larger. So you have add dimensions. This one, it shows 0.375, 16 UNC 2A. This is the part we are doing right now. 0.375 is the major diameter. Finish the sketch, extrude, and this one is going to be, if you do this calculation on this one, 4.1875 minus 0.435375 gives you 3.75. So that's the distance. Come back to the, repeat this process one more time. Select the circle, snap to origin, slightly larger. Diameter for this one is 0.625. This is 5.8, 0.625. Finish the sketch, extrude. This one is directly given 0.4375. Okay, so we have this shaft created. The next step is to add in the threads. So we're going to do exactly the same thing we did on the first one. Basically, it's the same type of the thread. It's a unified thread. For that, we're going to go back to expand your origin, select the same plane that you want to YZ plane in this case. New sketch. So I'm going to create the same triangle using the polygon, three sides, and select any place. Just zoom in here. Okay, selecting dimension. Okay, you tell me what the dimension should I type here. It's 16 UNC. That means 16 threads per inch. The pitch is, this is what we're creating. From one crest to another crest is 1/16 or 0.0625, 1/16. Okay, that is the size of the pitch, 0.0625. Okay, so again, same procedure. Bring this one using the project geometry. Select collinear. Okay, this time I need to move this one to coincident between this end. So we want to begin this end to this one. Starting point is not that critical, but in this case, it works best to do this from this point, this end, rather than from other end, because other end is the corner is hard to pick exactly. But here it's easy to pick that point. So you could start from that end too. And right now we have this triangle within that shade. I'm going to, this is already fully constrained, finish the sketch. Again, we are repeating the same process. Coil automatically picks for you. Notice that it's highlighted. And axis you have to define. Again, the same axis, Z axis. And again, you see the preview shows one revolution. That's the default. See, that shows one. Okay, what would be the size of the pitch? Is 1/16. Again, you type that, 1/16 in fraction form or decimal form. The revolution, this is the one, because again, I am selecting the type as a default selection. I did not change to any other options. These you would change if you need to, if you have something like height, if you know the pitch and height, or you know, in this case, we know the pitch of revolution. We can calculate that. So if I have 16 in every inch, how many do we have on 3.75? Remember, this shaft from here to here, we want to all be threaded. It's 3.75. 3.75 divided by 1/16, or 0.0625. If you do this in your calculator, you get some number. That number should be 60. And again, gives you the preview. If it goes in the right direction, it's fine. If it doesn't, then you can change the direction by selecting this. Or also make sure that you are selecting the cut. If you don't, you are adding the material. You are not going to see anything. Cut. So that's how you create this one too. This is pretty much the same as the first one. There are two things you need to add to this one to complete this part. First, you need to add that chamfer. If you go to back to the drawing, we have a, something we call chamfer. The chamfer size here is 1/32 by 45 chamfer, this part. So what this means that if you have basically here in this distance, if you think about the right triangle, which 45 degree triangle, both base are the same, right? Height and width are the same. So that is 1/32. So we have that tool for on the modeling, we have that. So it's like fillet, basically. You pick that edge, select the distance, divided by 1/32. And then select this edge. That takes care of that. One more thing, we have a hole going all the way through that. Let me just finish this one here. There's a hole that shows on this view. If you look back to this, this, I'm referring to this hole here, 0.25. Centered on the feature. That means both dimensions are the same. We need to make sure it's centered perfectly in this square shape that we see from that side. So let's go to complete that. So for this one, you select, you cannot pick at this face because this is rounded shape. What you need to do is to select one of these planes. Okay, in order to get that right orientation, select this same YZ plane, new sketch. And draw a circle and pick the somewhere. And then add dimensions, 0.25. You need to define this exactly in the center. I have not defined that yet, so just bring it somewhere here. Let me change the view so you can see inside. We will do the dimension. And adding this edge to the center here. It's going to be half of 0.4375 divided by 2. This way also we need to define this. I couldn't pick that line because I have not done the project geometry yet. That's a cylinder. So that's why I didn't pick. Now I should be able to. This total was 5658, and if you divide by that 2 would be 516. We can type that number divided by 2. 516. So that's fully constrained. Finish sketch and extrude. Let me go back to display the shade mode again under the view, visual style, shaded edge. Okay, if I go back to the 3D model and extrude, you should extrude this both symmetrical, both direction, and cut all. So that completes this assignment. Any questions?